Today we'll retell the incredible story of God's plan of redemption. It begins and ends with the matchless love of the Father for the people he created. It winds its way through the tragedy of the first sin in the Garden of Eden and spans the lives of men and women who responded in faith to God's word in their world. It goes by way of Bethlehem and Nazareth and Galilee. It reaches a glorious crescendo at Calvary and the Garden Tomb. There's only one possible title for this epic true account of how good triumphed over evil and love conquered all. This story is called Jesus Saved.
Thank you.
It was Passover, the night the nation celebrated how God had miraculously freed them from slavery in Egypt. Gathered with his closest friends, Jesus broke the unleavened bread and passed it around, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body." Then he offered the cup, saying, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins." The bread and the wine would be the way we would commemorate the sacrifice he was about to become. Still, he never stops reaching out to them, because God knows just how desperately people need him.
Oh, my God.
Jesus died and was buried. The crowd at Golgotha left. The disciples hid. His followers mourned. The Jewish leaders sighed with relief. And Jerusalem went back to normal. Then Sunday dawned. An angel rolled back the stone at the tomb so the world could see that it was empty. The angel said to the women who came to anoint his body, "You're looking for Jesus who was crucified. He isn't here. He has risen just as he said." This happened over 2,000 years ago, and yet that single event has changed history and the lives of countless souls around the world. We read of Bethlehem, follow his life on earth, hear his words, witness his death on the cross, and we believe in his resurrection. The drumbeat of truth becomes the heartbeat of our lives. It begins as a whisper and rises to a thundering roar. Jesus saves! Jesus saves! Jesus saves!
Our children, second grade and under, dismissed for their worship time. And if you would like to, you can stand while they're 28. Then I'd like for you to go ahead and take your Bible and turn.